Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. We can still hopefully expect another Falcon 9 launch this week. The launch of the Starlink 6-1 mission is scheduled for tomorrow, Thursday 23rd at 6:37pm UTC or 1:37pm EST. The launch of the Crew 6 mission is coming up very soon as well, and SpaceX posted these pictures of the Dragon capsule. They said Crew 6 Dragon arrives at LC-39A ahead of flight. Talking about the launch of Crew 6, as I mentioned, we can hopefully expect a liftoff very soon. The Crew 6 launch is currently scheduled for Sunday 27th at 6:45am UTC or 1:45am EST. Eric Berger posted a tweet related to Crew Dragon missions. He said SpaceX's Bill Gerstenmayer said the company may be prepared to launch crewed missions from Launch Complex 40 as soon as the third quarter of this year. There was a Starlink-related article posted. It says SpaceX has invited some customers to try out its new global roaming Starlink service, which costs around $800 up front. Global roaming customers will be charged $200 a month for the service and pay a one-time fee of $599 for the Starlink kit. There was another article posted related to Starlink price changes. It says price will rise $10 per month to $120 for users in limited capacity areas, while prices will drop $20 a month to $90 for those in excess capacity areas. Heading to Boca Chica, here's a view of the launch site. Work continues at the orbital launch pad with the work platform raised. This protective shielding was spotted being installed around the orbital launch mount. Jeff Faust posted a couple of tweets which could indicate that SpaceX only need to do final preparations and await FAA approval before Starship launches. The first says Gary Henry, Senior Advisor for National Security Space Solutions at SpaceX, says at a space mobility panel that both the Starship booster and pad are in good shape after static fire test earlier this month. The test was the last box to check before the first orbital launch. Then the second tweet said he adds that the company still needs an FAA launch license but expects that in the very near future. Tells the audience to expect some must-see TV sometime in March. The test nose cone was recently lifted and placed on the test stand. The work to scrap the Ship 22 prototype is continuing. Crews were seen going inside the Ship 24 payload section. Yesterday, SpaceX did some cryogenic testing of the naked Ship 26 prototype. Thomas Burchart posted a tweet with a picture of Ship 26 undergoing the cryoproof testing. The work on Booster 7 has been continuing. Taking a look at the road and beach closures on the Cameron County website, they tested Ship 26 yesterday. They did have additional possible closures for today and tomorrow, but those were cancelled. So currently there is only a possible closure for Friday 24th. As always, I have to say thanks to both Jack Beyer and Nick Ansuini for being out there filming the Boca Chica content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.